Let's do an example involving area functions. So here are the directions. The region bounded by f of t equals 2t and the t-axis from t equals 0 to t equals x forms a triangular shape. For x greater than or equal to 0, the area of this triangle is given by the area function, a of x equals the integral from 0 to x of 2t dt. And then we're asked to evaluate several things based on this information. So A, evaluate A of 5, B, evaluate A of 8, and C, find the area function y equals A of x for x greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so let's try to make sure we understand what's going on here. So we have this function f of t equals 2t, which is shown in my picture in the green line. All right, this is just a line of slope 2. And it forms, right, if I'm looking at the area under that curve, it forms a triangular shape with the x-axis, okay, from t equals 0 to t equals x. Now, t equals x, right, that's just some point on the t-axis, and that's a variable in my case, right? So I can move this x value around, like maybe x is here, or maybe it's here, or maybe it's here. And for any x value, I can form a triangle, and that triangle will just be maybe bigger or smaller. But x is a variable. It can move around. Okay, so then we're given an area function, right? So remember that the definite integral gives the net area under a curve, or some function. And so this is saying for x greater than or equal to 0, remember x is this value on the t-axis, for x greater than or equal to 0, the area of this triangle is given by this area function, okay? 0 to x of 2t dt. Okay, so that's what we're working with here. So then based on that, let's try and answer the following questions. So first I'm asked to evaluate a of 5. Okay, so what that's asking for is, so let's pretend that this x value is at 5. And then what's the area of the triangle in that situation? So what we want to do to evaluate that is we can plug in the 5 to the area function. So a of 5 then, so right, I'm plugging in 5 for x. So the integral from 0 to 5 of 2t dt. But then to evaluate this, I'm just going to use geometry, right? So if x is at 5, right, and I'm finding the area of a triangle here, well, what's this point up here? So to find the area of the triangle, I need to know the base and the height, right? And I know this base is going to be 5. But what about the height? Well, this function is 2t. And here, I'm plugging in 5, right? It's kind of confusing maybe because there's an x and a t, but they kind of represent the same thing in that they're both values along this horizontal axis, right? X just represents where I am along this t-axis, and it's called x because it's a variable. It can change. But now I'm looking specifically when x equals 5, so that's going to correspond to t equaling 5. So then to find the height, I'm just going to plug in 5 to this 2t, right? So the height's going to be 10. All right, so then to find the area of the triangle, I just use 1/2 base times height. So 1/2 base is 5, height is 10. Okay, so this is 1/2 times 50, which is 25. Okay, so in the case where x is 5, when that base is 5, then the area function, a of 5, gives us a value of 25. Okay, so let's do the same thing to evaluate a of 8. Okay, so now we're going to pretend that x has moved, and now it's sitting at a t value of 8. Okay, so then once again, to find the height of the triangle, I can use the fact that my function equals 2t. Okay, so if I plug in 8 there, I'm going to get a value of 16, right? So this function value here is 16, which gives me the height of my triangle. So then I'm going to do this the same way. So I can put it into my area function. A of 8 is the integral from 0 to 8 of 2t dt, which is asking for the net area under the curve. But I'm just going to use geometry once again to evaluate that. So 1/2 times 8 times 16. Well, I can think of that as 4 times 16, which is 64. Okay, so then the area function evaluated at x equals 8 gives me a value of 64. Okay, so the last thing I want to do then is I just want to find the area function in general. Right, so far we've evaluated A, the area function, at some specific values of x. But I just want to find the area function in terms of x for x greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so I'm told that A of x is the integral from 0 to x of 2t dt. Right, but let's see if I can just write down a function for that, one that doesn't involve the integral sign. So what have we been doing so far? Well, so far we've been using geometry to evaluate the area of this triangle, and we're going to do the same thing here, but we're going to leave everything in terms of x. Okay, so instead of thinking of x as a specific numeric value, I'm just going to think of it as x, as a variable. But this is going to work out the same way. So if I'm plugging in x to my function, then the height of the triangle is 2x. Okay, so I can still use the idea of the area of a triangle, which is 1/2 base times height. So the base is going to be given by x, right, because right, this is the length of the base, and the left endpoint here is at 0, right, so the distance of the side is x. So the base is x. And then the height of the triangle is given by the function value, and we just said that was 2x. Okay, so the 2's cancel, and I just end up with x squared. So I'm saying that the area function is x squared. So let's see if that agrees with the values we found so far. Well, when we plugged in 5, a of 5, we got 25, so that would agree. 5 squared is 25. And when we evaluated a of 8, we got 64. 8 squared, 64. Okay, so that makes sense. So notice one really important thing here. So the area function is x squared. And the original function was 2t. Now the variables are a little bit different, right? Because if we use x and t's, or if we use x's for both, it gets a little confusing. But ignore the difference in variables for a second. Just think about the functions, x squared, and we'll call it 2x. So those functions are related in a special way, right? If you take the derivative of x squared, that is the derivative of the area function, you get 2x, which is the function that is the original function, right? So hopefully this kind of starts getting you thinking about the relationship between the area function and the original function, and we'll explore this a little more. But just keep in mind the derivative relationship here.